we get new details from intelligence officials in Europe who've confirmed to CNN that Russian officers put bounties on American and British troops serving in Afghanistan.
That's right. CNN's Nick Peyton Walsh joins us now. And Nick, you actually spoke with intelligence officials. They confirmed that reporting.
Yeah, it's an extraordinary but also complex story here. The heart of it, though, is something very simple, that the European intelligence official I spoke to says that Russian military intelligence officers offered money to Taliban fighters in Afghanistan to kill American or other coalition fighters, a remarkable new development in what is still America's longest war. Now, the European intelligence official called this callous, shocking, and reprehensible, but also said he was bewildered by Russia's motivation here, because obviously to be caught in something like that is an exceptional geopolitical mess to find yourself in. I should point out the Russian embassy in Washington has said this is not true and used the hashtag blame Russia to dismiss the initial reports that emerged about this story in the New York Times. And the Taliban have also said they had nothing to do with this, that they're focused on peace talks and don't need foreigners to tell them how to conduct their military operations. An interesting detail in that this European intelligence official said to me that actually the particular part of Russian military intelligence responsible for this is known as 29155, and they're the unit that are also accused of being behind the poisoning in Salisbury in the United Kingdom in 2018 of the Skripal father and daughter. I don't know if you remember that. Most importantly here, though, the European intelligence official said to me that this offer of money had in fact resulted in casualties in the coalition. He wasn't clear on the nationality, the number, the date, or the nature, but it does show that this offer didn't just disappear as an idea. It caused something very real to happen. The White House itself, in its statement, has not come forward and denied these reports about the intelligence. They have instead chose to try and correct the New York Times' reporting that suggested President Donald Trump and his Vice President Mike Pence, who you heard from just there, were in fact briefed about it back in March. The White House says that is not true. But a startling choice of kind of denial for the White House to put out, not confronting Russia's action, instead discussing whether or not Donald Trump was briefed about it. And you have to wonder, why would he not be told about something like this? And this yet again complicates matters in Afghanistan. That war continues, America's longest. Donald Trump very keen to get out. So you have to ask, why would Russia perhaps complicate matters by trying to foment further American casualties? A very complicated matter here, sir. Certainly, what's not complicated is the strength of the allegations here. Russian military intelligence paid or tried to pay Taliban fighters to get them to kill Americans. A startling accusation in itself.
Hey, Nick, before we head back to the White House, I want to know about the U.S. troops who have been targeted. Are we hearing anything from Downing Street about the British troops who've been targeted? Anything publicly?
No.
Hmm.
In short, no, not at all. And while it is clear that British troops were also possibly part of those targeted here as well, the European intelligence official I've spoken to speaks more about the wider coalition potentially having been targeted here. So, of course, one of the details that people will be trying to get the answer to is exactly who the casualties were that were caused by this alleged offer or payment of money by Russian military intelligence. But it is startling, frankly, to see the depth of the allegations of Russian meddling in Afghanistan, the callousness, frankly, of them trying to foment something like this, and at the same time, too, the White House choosing to deny part of the report, but not all of it. And Joe Biden, you heard there, strident in his response.
Nick Peyton Walsh for us there in London. Nick, thank you so much for the reporting. And let's focus now on Joe Biden, a Democratic presidential candidate, I should say, the likely nominee, slamming President Trump on this Russia report. Watch.
Not only has he failed to sanction or impose any kind of consequences on Russia for this egregious violation of international law, Donald Trump has continued his embarrassing campaign of deference and debasing himself before Vladimir Putin. He has this information, according to the Times, and yet he offered to host Putin in the United States and sought to invite Russia to rejoin the G7. His entire presidency has been a gift to Putin, but this is beyond the pale. It's a betrayal of the most sacred duty we bear as a nation, to protect and equip our troops when we send them in the harm's way.
A damning indictment there from Joe Biden. Let's bring back Sarah from the White House. And Sarah, 24 hours after this story broke. Now, this really struck me that they waited 24 hours for the White House to finally issue a response saying that the president and vice presidents were never briefed on this intelligence. That alone is a stunning statement, but many experts aren't buying it.
That's right. And as Nick mentioned, the White House not choosing to deal with the actual root of the allegation there. They're not choosing to deal with the subject matter, but just denying that the specific reporting that the president and the vice president were briefed on that intelligence. The White House statement even clearly said that it does not speak to the merit of the alleged intelligence. So they're not denying that those bribes from the Russians did take place. And the Office of the Director of National Intelligence also issued a rare public statement on this, siding with the White House, saying that no such briefing took place. But again, the intelligence director there also not denying the underlying allegations. And so the criticism here is more that the White House has been silent on the allegations themselves, even though they have spoken out in response to the news stories at this point, Vianna and Victor.
Yeah, Sarah Force there, nothing from the president himself. Instead, he spent the day playing golf and tweeting about monuments to Confederate generals. Sarah Westwood Force there at the White House, thanks so much.